Hello all, in this video we are going to discuss about the basis behind isolation, quarantine and social distancing, especially in context of this COVID-19 pandemic. For any disease pathogen, to establish the disease, it has to enter into the human body. Here in this case, it is COVID-19 virus or SARS-CoV-2. So after the entry of the virus, it multiplies within the human body. Then after some time, the virus get released into the environment from the body, but the person looks healthy. Then after some time, the person start developing some symptoms of the disease. Here in case of COVID-19, the three cardinal symptoms are fever, cough and breathlessness. Then after some time, the appearance of the symptoms will be followed by the cessation of the symptoms. Then after the cessation of the symptoms, the virus release stops. Usually in other diseases, the virus release point and the appearance of the symptoms overlaps, and the cessation of the symptoms and the virus release stopping point overlaps. Even though it is a novel coronavirus, epidemiologists have come to the conclusion that the virus get released before the appearance of the symptoms, and after the cessation of the symptoms, the virus release stops. The time interval between the virus entry and the appearance of the symptoms is called as incubation period. And the time interval between the virus release from the body to the virus release stoppage is called as the period of communicability or period of infectivity. Now, what is quarantine and isolation? Quarantine is the old procedure followed in ships during the plague times. Persons from the ship has to wait in the port for 40 days in order to prove them that they are free of any disease. Then they will be allowed into the mainland. Quarantine is for the exposed or to the contacts with the COVID-19 persons, and isolation is for the person who are sick or persons showing symptoms of the disease. How long the person has to be quarantined is for the maximum incubation period. Here in this case it is 14 days. And isolation, how long the person has to be isolated is the maximum period of infectivity or communicability. And where they have to be quarantined, the home contacts can be quarantined in their home itself, and the person who are traveled from air can quarantine in specialized centers, and the person who are isolated has to stay in hospital and get treatment there. So all the COVID positive cases has to stay in hospital. That's why in hospital this will be called as isolation ward or isolation hospital. The places of quarantine are called as quarantine centers. This is the slide showing the number of days or the time along the x-axis, and along the y-axis we have the spectrum of the disease, starting from no symptoms to mild or moderate symptoms to severe symptoms to critical symptoms. There are three important things which we should learn from this slide. The first important point in this slide is the incubation period. The mean incubation period and also the median incubation period falls around 5 days after exposure to the virus. The second important point is the timeline of period of communicability. Patients can be communicable up to 25 days, that too if they are critical and severe. But as the patient is becoming mild and moderate severe, the period of communicability also reduces. When they have no symptoms, they can approximately communicable up to 14 days. So the isolation of COVID positive patients who are asymptomatic can be done for a period of 14 days, should turn negative in order to be out of isolation. That too two times negative result should come. And the third important point here is the asymptomatic state of the disease. As long as the disease is having mild symptoms, then the period of contagiousness will slightly prolong. Now, what is mean by social distancing? There are three components in social distancing. Keeping distance between the individuals, at least 2 meters. We should avoid shaking hands. Number 3, when we are sneezing, we should sneeze into our arm or tissue to reduce the spread of the germs. In my previous presentation about COVID-19, I have mentioned 2 important measures to control COVID-19 were frequent hand washing and social distancing. At that point of time, Government of India and also World Health Organization were not recommending mask to everybody. Because the numbers have gone up, both World Health Organization and Indian government recommends wearing of face mask by everybody is recommended. Even though this will not prevent you from breathing in the respiratory droplets carrying the virus, this will protect the people around if you are infected but don't have symptoms. They can help reducing the spread of the germs. They can prevent touching the face. They can be a visual reminder to practice social distancing. If everyone wears them, it could help cut down how far the virus spreads. So to sum up, what is social distancing, quarantine and isolation? Everyone should practice social distancing until the pandemic ends. The person who are exposed to the COVID-19 patients should self-quarantine themselves, self-monitor themselves, check for fever and other respiratory symptoms for 14 days after exposure. The person who are symptomatic, that is with fever, cough and respiratory symptoms, should self-isolate in hospitals. How long they should be isolated? It is no less than 7 days from the symptom onset and also 72 hours after the fever disappears, and improvement in respiratory symptoms along with 2 COVID-19 negative results. Thanks for watching this video.